In the last video, we took a look at this interesting idea of Fermat's theorem that said that if we ever came across a function that had a local min or maximum somewhere, and if the derivative existed at that point, the derivative would have to be equal to zero. So we're going to go ahead and keep this idea in mind as we work through the next example here in example 4. We're going to be taking a look at the simple function of x cubed. And I'm going to ask you to go ahead and actually see if you can try to answer each of the following questions here in parts A through C. So go ahead right now, pause the video and see if you can try to work out the answers to each of these questions. And then when you go ahead and unpause the video, you'll see me work through the solutions. All right, so hopefully you actually did go ahead and try this out. Let's see how we could answer part A. If I'm interested in finding the values of x that make the first derivative equal to zero, the first thing I would have to do is actually calculate the first derivative. Right now, that's super easy because all that's going to require is a simple power rule. And if what we want is to have our first derivative equal to zero, I can state something like we see that 3x squared will be equal to zero only if x is equal to 0, right? Because I could divide by 3 and square root, and I would ultimately end up with x is equal to 0. So f prime of x is equal to 0 only when x is equal to 0. So there's a tangent line of slope 0 only when x is the value of 0. Well, now part B comes into play. If I think about what Fermat's theorem said, it said if there's a local minimum or maximum at a point, and if the derivative exists, then it must be equal to zero. So the question that I have is there a local min or local max of our function at any of the values that we found in part A? That is, at zero, is there a min or a max? And if we really quickly just think about what the graph of this function actually looks like, I'll go ahead and sketch it out here in red. If this is my cube function, again, one of my graphs to know, it looks like this. And I can see then that at this value of x equals 0, right, there's going to be a tangent line in here that's apparently horizontal, that's a flat tangent line. So there's a tangent line here that kind of looks something like this. So I could ask the question, though, is there a local min or a local max at that point? And my answer here should be no. There's not, because notice even if I was to take a look at a little window around this point, I could see that at x equals 0, this is certainly not a highest or a lowest point within that window. And so I have to answer automatically no. And you might be thinking, well, wait a minute then. Didn't Fermat's theorem just tell me that if I have a slope of 0 for a tangent line, then I get a min or a max? And no, that's not what Fermat's theorem said. Fermat's theorem said, and we have to be careful here to read this in the order it's presented. It says, if you start with a local min or max, if you already know you have a min or a max, and you calculate the derivative and get a number, then that derivative value should be zero. But that requires that you started with a min or a max. Notice here, when we got to x equals 0, we didn't know if at x equals 0 there was going to be a minimum or a maximum, or maybe if there was going to be neither of those two things. So, this leads us to our important part C. You'll notice here, it's almost the reversal of Fermat's theorem in terms of its sentence structure. Fermat's theorem started with the idea of local mins and maxes and ended with the idea of our derivative equal to 0. Take a look here. This says, let's suppose we come across a function g, and we know that g prime of c, that is g prime at some x value, gives us 0. There's some tangent line of slope 0 on the graph. Then g must have, it must have a local min or a max at c? This is a question, right? Because it's true, false. Is that true? And we would say, no, it's definitely not. And the perfect counterexample is right here. Just because I get a tangent line of slope 0 doesn't mean that I'm ultimately going to end up with a min or a max. So part C is telling us something really, really important here. What it's showing us is that Spots on the graph where we get a tangent line of slope 0 are kind of like potential candidates for where there might be mins and maxes. At x equals 0, there was a horizontal tangent, which means there might have been a min or a max at that point, but it's not guaranteed. So this provides us with an interesting idea. Maybe what we can do is we can try to find mins and maxes on a graph by looking at all of the spots where I get a slope that's equal to 0 or a slope that's undefined. And if I do this, then maybe there will be mins and maxes there. Those are at least the potential spots where a min or a max might occur. There are potential candidates. In fact, these points are so important that we're going to give them a name. And here's kind of the name that we'll give them, as well as an important fact. First, I'll read the fact. And again, it'll highlight why we're going to name these. If a function has a local min or a max at C, then C is in the domain of F, and either we're going to, again, have at that local min or max a tangent line of slope 0 or a tangent line slope that does not exist. And so we're going to look for, again, all the points that could make our derivative equal to 0 or not exist. And we'll call these points critical points of the function because they are critical to understanding where these mins and maxes are. So a critical number, again, is going to be just an x value where that makes our first derivative equal to 0 or undefined, makes it not exist. So let's go ahead and see how we're going to, we'll start to see how we're going to go ahead and use this idea in many of the examples to come. We'll see that we'll constantly be trying to take derivatives and figure out what values of x make it 0 and what values of x make it undefined. And after doing this, we then have at least the list of potential spots where we may have mins and maxes.